Stampers, welcome to Stamping Mama. I'm Eileen Judd, your Stampin Up demonstrator. Today we are making a watercolor balloon card using the Lift Me Up stamp set from the Occasions catalog. And we'll be casing this card from the front cover of the Occasions catalog. And we'll also be using the find in some of the DSP from the called Carried Away Designer Series paper, and it's one of the free items you can get when you purchase $50 before sales and tax and shipping through March 31st. So take advantage of that, because this will come in a bundle with this, and so when you get this as a bundle, then and a little something else, you should be, you'll save 10% off the bundle plus maybe a little piece of cardstock or whatever. And then, you know, what you do after you reach that, then you can get the matching DSP, the Carried Away Designer Series paper, for free to go along with this set. So I think that's a pretty good deal. We are also using the watercolor pencils from the Occasions catalog. So get ready to learn some fun techniques. And we'll start with the base. And I'm using thick Whisper White cardstock. For sizes and dimensions, please head on over to my website, stampingmama.com, or click the direct link to the post in the description box below. And just don't worry about taking notes, just sit back and relax. Using watercolor paper and Bermuda Bay pencil, we're going to create the background, and I'll just start from the bottom. I just discovered no matter how dark you put it in one area, it really won't show up. And don't worry, the lines for the most part won't show up when you watercolor. And take the aqua painter and just work your way up the page, and feel free to go off the page. Now, just pretend like this is your own designer series paper. Just going over any spots that I missed. And set that side to dry. While I wait for that to dry, I want to take the thin let die. Of course, I mean, the maximize my space so I can use this again. I'm going to trace around, and this is watercolor paper. This will be the backing, and the tricky part is try not to get it to move because I'm not right above it. It is certainly making this interesting. Don't worry about the lines, because when you cut, you'll basically be cutting them off, because we want this to be slightly smaller than this framelit. So it won't show up around and being just pinpoint it, you know. This is the backing for the balloon. And so that's how you make the backing, is by tracing the thinlet die on the watercolor paper and then cutting it out. Cut this out. Sort of like fussy cutting. To see if you got it right, this is what you'd put the watercolor paper behind that, and if you see any white areas you need to fix. Fix it. And you may have to fix a little bit more later, but for now, that will do. And we'll take the opportunity to color the balloon with watercolor pencils. I'm just trying to mimic the pattern that's on the one I made. Melon Mambo. Scribble here. It really depends on what you want. And bring in some Bermuda Bay. I'm going for the bright colors. I just thought it was really cool it was a multicolored water balloon when I saw the card on the cover of the catalog, and I thought, oh, neat. Like, I wanted to try it. So I'm hoping you're enjoying this. I'm having some, a little bit of the travel berry. And pumpkin pie. Can't forget about good old pumpkin pie. Using the aqua painter. I think best thing to do is try to head into the light color to the dark colors. A little bit darker than I intended. So you can go back and fix it if you need to. Try to thicken the color. It's not as easy. Doing this when the paper is still damp. Just gotta play with it a little, but definitely when you try this, color it in small circles and dark, and take your time with it. because if you try to rush it, then it might not turn out the way you want it. Like, it's not completely turned out the way I want it, but I think it's going to look just fine when I put the thin lid on top of it. So it should be okay. Set that aside to dry on watercolor paper. We're going to take the big balloon on tempting turquoise. The reason why I'm having to rub this, this is an older pad. It's not the newer foamy ones. So be gentle and use the foamy ones. And I'm going to stamp upside down onto the watercolor paper. And then with Daffodil Delight, do the same thing. I'm going to set that aside. And I want to show you what framelits we're going to use and run through the big shot. This thinlet, the small balloon, the medium balloon, this cloud, that cloud, the three lumps, and this cloud. For us on dazzling details, I want to run the clouds through multiple times on the big shot. Using the magnet platform, you're going to run this through on Whisper White cardstock. Ideally, you'd use a precision plate for this, but I didn't grab this time, and as long as you run it through a couple of times, it should be okay. I'm going to run these through together. That aside. To watch me do this a few times. We're going to take the balloon using the roller. We have that and the balloon using a fine tip glue pen. Just random places. Now, if you can see that, there's extra pieces, so I need to cut those off. Just carefully go around. It's like the paper had expanded when I watercolored it. So, keep that in mind. Hey, pretty balloon. Set the balloon aside. Try to move the scraps. Grab the base. And I just used strips of the DSP. I didn't use a whole bunch. I like to conserve my designer series paper. For fun stuff. Hopefully I didn't make these too long. Every card will be a little different because the DSP strips will be different, so it won't be the same thing every time. And we're going to adhere down. I'm using Tombow glue. You can use whatever adhesive you want. It's up to you what you're most comfortable with. I highly suggest not using glue sticks because your cards will fall apart in the mail. So don't do that. I see people do that and I cringe. I don't want you guys doing that stuff. So I highly suggest a craft glue or snail or fast fuse. Try to center that. best as possible. And then we'll bring in the cloud. And I goofed a little bit here. I was supposed to glue the clouds on first before I glued the watercolor part. Because some of the clouds go off and then you have to cut off the extra clouds. So I goofed a little bit there. So try to avoid doing what I just did. But we'll be able to figure this out. This cloud here, and I'll just eyeball it. Little one over here. One thing I almost forgot was these balloons. And what we're going to do with the watercolor aqua painter is take the color that we stamped down, isn't this neat, and just spread it around. Do the little basket, and then clear it out and do the same thing for the daffodil delight bloom. I don't have to worry about the basket on that one because he's super tiny. And let these little dudes dry because we still need to stamp our sentiment with Memento ink. Hopefully I get this guy right. Hopefully it's not too runny. That's weird. Flip it over. I think there's some sort of piece of paper on that. That will do, although it's a little bit wider than I thought it should be. I'll just do my best to cut this off straight. I don't have my paper cutter nearby. And then we'll cut little flaggy ends. I'm gonna cut a little bit off this side. That's too pointy. Let's try to fix that. Being too pointy. Sometimes you just gotta figure things out. I will have the correct dimensions for that piece of paper on my website, so no need to worry about that. I can go ahead and add the, oh, of course I ran out of glue. Let's get my other one. Cute. I'm gonna get ink all over myself. And then we will glue down the little balloons. Right about here. You can use glue dots for the balloons if you want. I just don't want to use a whole bunch of dimensionals, and then if I try to send it that way, then post office will send it back to me saying too bulky. It's things you gotta be careful about. This yellow balloon over here, and then using Stampin dimensionals. Now you notice here I didn't fill in the basket. I decided not to do that. I didn't mind it so much, but if you want to fill in the basket, there is a die for that to put a backing for the basket at least. Just trying to make sure that if when I send this, I like putting lots of dimensionals things, so when I send it through the mail, it won't get crushed. And it won't, someone won't pull out the card and it's all wavy and bent and looks weird. I want it to look the way I sent it. If you understand that. Woo! And place the balloon right about here, and voila, check out this card. Isn't it sparkly? If you don't already have a catalog, please request a free one from me by clicking the link upper right hand corner or below in the description box. And I would love to earn your business. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more tutorials and follow me on my website. Until next time, happy crafting!